It was 20 years ago.
Every Little League coach wears more than one hat, and Dave Wottle is no different. He's instructor. He's father. He's cheerleader. But in 1972, Wottle wore only one hat, and in two trips around the track in Munich, it made him famous.
I had a hat that looked almost identical to this that I wore in the Olympic Games. I started wearing it for very practical reasons. You know, it was a sweatband, it was a sun visor, it kept the hair out of my eyes. People started not knowing who I was without the hat, you know. If I didn't have it on, I was incognito.
But it wasn't just the hat that caught people's attention. At the Olympic trials, he surprised everyone by tying a world record in the 800 meters. Still, he wasn't picked to win in Munich. He was, after all, inexperienced, injured, and he did something head track coach Bill Bowerman felt was distracting. He got married.
Here I am, the biggest moment in my track career, and I'm injured, and I can't train, and I'm losing it. You know, she gave me the moral support that I needed at that time when I was really feeling down.
The favorite was the Soviet great, Yevgeny Arjanov. He was also the reigning European champion. Wottle's immediate strategy was to fall out of the pack all the way back into dead last.
I can remember that first turn, looking up in the stands and thinking, all your friends at home are just going to kind of laugh at you and say, you know, could have at least been in the race, you know, you could have caught up. And that's all I was trying to do.
But Wottle had another trademark, a finishing kick that made up lost ground in a big hurry. Then again, so did Arjanov.
At the top of the stretch, though, he still had such a large distance and such a short period of time for me to catch him. I was really only going after third place.
Wottle passed one Kenyan runner and then another. Arjanov would fling himself at the finish line, but too late. Wottle and his hat had won.
On the victory stand after the 800 meters, I forgot I even had it on. I didn't know it was on my head during the national anthem.
Today, Waddle's hat resides in a place of permanent honor, right next to Jesse Owens' shoes in the National Track and Field Hall of Fame. As for the man under the hat, 20 years and a gold medal have done little to change Dave Wottle. As Dean of Admissions for Rhodes College in Memphis, Tennessee, he's a self-confessed paper shuffler. And just like the guy next door, he's got kids, a mortgage, and Little League.
When I achieved that goal of winning the Olympics, I was ready to get back and go on with other things in my life. I just wanted to prove that I was the best in the world on that particular day. I think people remember more the hat than they do me anymore. It was my trademark, and I think I'll probably never outlive the hat.